But let's go to a Wales fan, David, who's a big Wales fan. David?
Is it David?
It's David, yeah.
It's David. Yeah. Sorry, David. Good evening, David.
Good evening. How are you?
Yeah, we're great. Happy with tonight's performance?
Absolutely, yeah. I think we Belgium were lucky to come away with a draw, to be honest with you.
Yeah, but you know what? You go in seeded now into the playoffs. Can you make it to the World Cup?
Well, I think we've given ourselves the best chance we've ever had of doing it. Because, I mean, you look at the teams that are seeded alongside us. You look at, you know, Portugal, Italy. We didn't want to be playing them. So
you've avoided the big heads.
Yeah. But for one game. But, I mean, being Welsh, we've never, you know, not in my lifetime have we ever reached a World Cup. So, yeah, we've given ourselves the best chance possible. So why not be positive? Why not? Why can't we do it? And we've done it tonight without Gareth Bale as well. Do you know what I mean? Everybody said we're a one-man team, so...
Well, Cundy said that.
You can't... I mean, without Gareth Bale, he is the...
What are Wales without Gareth Bale?
Dog and Duck. I said that last time.
Shocking.
They were without Gareth Bale. Gareth Bale is the man. But I have to say, since then, the emergence of Dan James... He is absolutely the one that can actually turn defence into attack.
Kiefer Moore, Aaron Ramsey.
Do you know what I mean? Ramsey's always been there. You know, Ramsey and him were the two.
But he was dog and duck before Gareth Bale.
Yeah, without, you need Gareth Bale. He's absolute pomp.
You guys have missed the guy who's changed, who's been dominant in the last two games is Nico Williams.
Yeah, he has been. Very good. Yeah, I agree with you. They've got a good side. They put a very good side together. And look, David, do you... When you get to the World Cup, if you get to the World Cup, are you happy to see home nations there? If you went out, would you support England?
No. I'm not going to lie and sugarcoat it, no. No. As same as you English, don't want us Welsh to do well. It's nice for us all to be there. It's nice to see the Scottish. I don't particularly want the Scottish to do well either, or the Irish. When you're there, it's dog eat dog. But it's nice for everybody to be in the pot to start with, and then see what happens. But no, I'm not gonna stand here and say, yeah, I'm an English supporter.
Dog eat dog or dog eat duck, depending which way you look at it. Just quickly, Dave. Only messing with Dave. Dave, who do you want? Poland, North Macedonia, Austria, the Czech Republic. Can you get the Czech Republic? Because they're in
Europe. Yeah.
You can get them, right? Turkey or Ukraine? Who's the one you're looking at?
I don't think there's an easy draw on any of them. We should have beat Czech Republic in the group. So as long as we're home, when we got the red wall behind us, there's only
you are at home. That's the whole point of finishing seeded.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. As long as we're at home, it doesn't matter who we're playing.
Yeah.
We could be playing England and we'll still win. You know what I mean?
Say that.
David, thanks for your call.
Cheers, David.
Keep them coming in. 03-717-223-344. Let's go to Dan, who's a Cardiff fan. Dan, good evening.
Hey boys, how's it going?
Yeah, very good. You must be buzzing.
Buzzing like a fridge. Yeah, just just got out the stadium and fair play. They played really, really well. We nullified Belgium, and let's be honest, at Belgium they're number one in the world, but they can pass the ball around. But hardly any chances, and like your other caller said, I think we had a couple of the better chances there in the second half, and we could have nicked it. But to be honest, I mean, if you'd have said to me 1-1, I would have bitten your hand off.
Yeah, I mean, and look, it gives you a great opportunity. You go in seeded into the playoffs. Is there anyone there you fancy playing? Poland, North Macedonia, Austria, Czech Republic, Turkey, or Ukraine? I guess any of them, really.
I mean, I'll take North Macedonia, but I mean, they've come a long way.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you reckon? I mean, yeah, I mean, like you know, the caller said, we're home. So, I mean, I'd take any of those. And it was the main one was finishing second, because, let's be honest, no one wants to play Italy or Portugal. But, you know, I mean, we've avoided them for one match. But if we get in our final, it's like a cup final, isn't it? So, you know, whoever's, you know, the better team on the day. But I think we can do it. We're never going to get a better chance than we have now. We've put ourselves in a great position. But I mean, it's nice to talk about Wales and another team rather than England. You know what I mean? I mean, watched the England the other night, 10-0. I mean, I'm
not interested. I wasn't interested in it, Dan, to be honest with you, but...
Well, maybe if you got to a World Cup every now and then, Dan, it might help.
Well, listen, I mean, we got to the Euros, didn't we, in the end? I mean, that was a great achievement in itself last time. I mean, we got to 2 Euros, yeah. Got to the semi-finals and a knockout stages. I mean, to see how far we've come,
yeah,
in the past few years, I mean, it's such a great achievement. And I couldn't be prouder, to be honest. And like the other caller said there, that Nico Williams, I'm telling you what, phenomenal.
Yeah, he's come on a huge amount, hasn't he, in the last 18 months plus.
I mean, I think they've shown that they can actually cope without Gareth Bale a little bit, Wales, do you think, Dan?
Yeah, 100%. 100%. Totally agree with you. I mean, sometimes...
I mean, look, he's the shining light, obviously, but...
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's a world-class player. I mean, like, you've got plenty of world-class players in the England squad. I mean, we're not blessed like England. I mean, we're a small nation. But, I mean, as a collective unit, we have got some fantastic players there. And they gel. They play really, really well together. And on paper, you look at it and you think, oh, they got half a decent team there. And we can go and give anyone a good game, like this evening. It's just proven, you know, I know they've been missing a couple of players, but... I'm buzzing. I'm sat in a van. I've just come out of the stadium. I've had a cheeky McDonald's.
What have you got to say? Cheeky? Are they ever cheeky? What's the cheeky McDonald's?
I say cheeky because the wife don't know. So I mean,
it's cheeky.
Chicken sandwich meal. I mean, I know there are other fast food chains out there, right. But I have a chicken sandwich meal and. With a latte and a triple cheeseburger. The triple cheeseburger.
Thanks for that order, Dan. Just a question: does the missus, has she made you dinner for when you get home?
No, she I made her dinner actually because I had to leave early. She's a nurse, so she was home late. So literally, I had the in-laws. This is how desperate I was. I had to get the in-laws to come up to babysit the kids, so I had to leave in time to make sure I was there in time, so I wasn't late.
Fair enough.
I made her a tuna pasta bake, so that was on the side, and she thinks I've already eaten, but you know she won't know, and she won't listen to this because she hates football. So I got away with one.
Thanks, Dan. Thanks for your insight into McDonald's.
Cheers,
and tuna pasta bake. Keep your calls in 03717 22 33 44.